okay, just got myself in trouble, yeah. Like, one of my close friends, she's trying to lose weight, innit? Yeah. But I didn't know that, innit? So she's come up to me and got, she's just walking around the place. And she's like, I lost 2 pounds, you know? I lost 2 pounds. Oh my gosh, I lost 2 pounds. So I gave her £2, innit?
It's Max, the cab driver. If we need a lift, I'll take it there. I might even chat to you and give you a cold interview. Talking all types of things like media, politics, knowledge is power. Remember, it's my view and my view only. If you don't like it, come out my cab.
Me say, whoa, down, one big up all the guy them that come first. No, them pan the second, no, them pan the third, them all about the first. One big up all the guy them, already? You know about this tune, man. You know about this tune, though. You know about this tune. First kid!
Jeez!
What? Jeez. Yeah, man! I'm here with, right, there's bare names for this body now, you know. Peer names. You got Prince Harry, but I'm gonna go with White Yardie. Like, why White Yardie? Except for the obvious. I know you're white, but I, and then you got the Yardie. Where did it come from?
Well, you're just saying it, White Yardie, innit? You explain it. But no, obviously, yeah, come from Jamaica, so you know them call Jamaicans Yardie, innit?
Yeah, but why did they call it? Then it's the, obviously that's a gangster.
You know, it's just a nick, like a, it's almost like a nickname thing, innit? You know, like, yeah, you can associate it with gangster life and them thing there, but I don't really that. Them just, it's easier than saying Jamaicans or Jamaicans, so them say Yardies, innit? You know, I think, what it is, yeah, see, we Jamaicans, yeah, when we say home, you know, we don't say back at home, we say back at yard.
Back at yard.
So, you know what I mean? So, yeah, we call Jamaica yard. So, it's almost like a nickname for Jamaica, innit? Yard. So, you didn't just yard, innit?
Just put the IE at the end of it.
Yeah. So, that's where it come from.
So, what's the Prince Harry then?
Prince Harry, my name's originally Harry, innit?
So, oh, okay. Oh,
so, that's my real name. My real name's Harry. And when we decided to take up comedy, I decided to say, yo, which name if you go by, because people know me as Yardie.
Uh-huh.
Enough people call me Yardie, you get me? Like, that's a name where they were with me for a long time, you get me? So when I decided to say, yo, I go do comedy, I think of a name where now I go throw the people them off, you know, because I never want to just go with White Yardie by itself, and then, you know, you might depend on a flyer or anything. Or imagine you walk and you see a poster and you say, White Yardie. You know, it might look a bit strange. And
so Prince Harry is what you go by now. So really and truly, yeah. Really people stop still using White Yardie then, innit?
No, you know what, them still use it, and to be fair, me no mind them using it, because
I prefer White Yardie, man.
Because I feel like the people them know me more that way, you get me? Because when people say Prince Harry, then they be like, who? And then they say White Yardie, then be like, oh!
Oh!
Yeah, so,
you're white, obviously.
Yeah,
like, you're all white through. You're none of this, like, a bit of black hair or touch of... Yeah. You know, no white, no black, touch
no,
of black.
No.
Literally.
Yeah.
So, all right. How's the reception from our people and also from the white people? Like, how is the reception?
Yeah, you know, it's mixed. It's a very mixed reception, because first off, yeah, enough people shocked by it. Them look and say, yo.
Like, it's like putting your foot in cold water.
Yeah, you know, so sometimes you get the people them saying, want the white boy I try be black and them thing.
So have you heard it? You've heard that from their mouth?
Me hear people say it, and to me, I just laugh when me hear that, because what it is that's somebody who has not spent time to educate themselves.
Boom.
You understand what I mean? That's somebody who is not taking their time to read a book or do some research.
Bullet!
Because the thing is, you know, is that enough people not realizing, you know, white people were the first slaves in Jamaica, you know.
Ah, the people.
No, enough
education.
People. Education. Yeah, enough people don't realize that white people were the first slaves. But the reason why that not really debunked, because the heat, white people couldn't stand the heat working out in the fields. And it's true. So, in the end, it never worked out for the slave masters at the time. So that's when they went to Africa, and then they brought the Africans over.
Okay.
But
okay.
The white people were still slaves, just they moved them into the house. And they were house slaves.
Oh,
so we
right.
had to do all of the washing and them thing there, and the feeding and the cleaning. And yeah, so that enough people don't understand that. So back to when you was asking, like, so some people always say, yo, me, I tried this, me tried did that, but Jamaica is multicultural.
Mm-hmm.
You get me? Jamaica, you have every single different, you can go in Jamaica right now and find every single person in Jamaica. From Chinese back to probably find all Africans, they're like proper Africans.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I real talk, man, so yeah, it's a mixed reception at first, but once them listen more and more to me and start taking me more and more, that's kind of faded out now.
So that's kind of, you're saying from the black perspective, that's what they're kind of, or is it both sides?
Both sides are the same thing. You get a mix from it. Some people understand it, some people believe it, some people don't believe it, some people open it.
Could you imagine an old guy and look, yeah, no, we got to check this out because he can't be real, he must be a fake. Mm. And then they got to check out your history and go through.
Yeah, man, enough of them do it, man. They don't question it and things like that, but at the end of the day, I mean, I have nothing to prove to nobody, you know.
Nah, that's simple. Alright, so it going a bit deeper.
Mm.
Alright.
Deep, dog.
You know, got too deep, you know. But I'm thinking now, everything. Right, society is crazy at the moment, especially for a black man, innit? It's bloody crazy. Jobs, opportunities, all them things there, yeah? Now, how do you sit with that now? Like, knowing that you can go between the two cultures, innit?
Mm-hmm.
Black and white, whatever kind of thing. How do you sit in terms of the black culture, in terms of seeing what we're going through in society today, like how we're perceived, how we're looked upon, you know what I'm saying?
You know, funny enough, yeah, see like this, ca back in, your phone ringing?
Yeah, yeah, no, it's my mum keeps sending me emails, I don't understand. I keep telling her I'm busy, it's because I don't want to answer the phone to her.
So she's sending an email?
Yeah, she's sending me emails.
Not a text message?
No, no.
She writes an email.
Because she knows I read the text message, so she sends me the, it's really weird.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, okay, match. Alright, me get it. Man, so email that to me, email. Know what this. Yeah, we do, alright, see with that now, it's with me, it's crazy because one thing with me, you see, when growing up in Jamaica, somebody's race has never been an issue to me.
I
don't think it's ever been an issue to anybody. Like, me never really encounter racism till me come to England.
Then, alright, yeah, okay, mean, okay. So over there, you just
to me, them things don't never exist. Certain things never really understand. I never get to understand what I mean.
Mm.
Obviously, we know about history and we know about slaves and them things because that's Jamaican history.
Mm-hmm,
but
mm-hmm.
I mean, I encounter racism and them things there. Obviously, coming to a country which is predominantly like a white country, you could mm-hmm. say then, yeah, you notice all the black culture is dealt with different and them things there. But to me, I feel like sometimes, I feel like it's like what Bob Marley say, you know, emancipate yourself from mental slavery, you know.
Emancipate yourself from... Okay.
So it's like, I feel like we need to stop dwell on the past too much.
Mm-hmm.
And just think about the positives what we can get in life, man. And I, right now, when you think about it, you know, it's down to... It's not even... I don't even think it's down to a white or a black thing no more. I think it's just down to we need to stop this whole thing. It's because me this, because me that.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you think about it, if you want to be a doctor, you can be a doctor.
Straight.
If you want to be a lawyer, you can be a lawyer.
Straight.
Anything you want to be. The only way your race will come into play is if that the person that is hiring you
mm-hmm.
is a racist person.
And if that's where the problem
that
is though. It.
Yeah, that no, but that's true. If that person who is hiring you is not racist, you stand the same chance as a normal person, any other person. You understand? So if so a white man and a black man going to a job interview, if the person is interviewing you is white, it don't mean say yo through the white man, white and him white, him go employ you. It means that if that person is picking, if you're better skilled than that white person, mm-hmm. you will get the job. The only way you won't get a job if the man is racist. And that is my opinion anyway. My opinion is my opinion. Nobody else have entitled to them opinion. I do understand that certain companies kind of have a way of how they would like their companies to look
mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm,
they think mm-hmm, that, yeah mm-hmm. cool, but I feel say yo right now them think they kind of it's deep, isn't it? It's a deep one. But
so you're saying to people now, like people out there, you're literally saying look, you can do any. The world is our oyster now.
Yeah, man.
We know the past. Yeah. Don't forget it, but move on and progress.
And that's it. Because
but you do realize the difference between you've pointed one thing that you've come over here and you felt it.
Yeah, man. Definitely.
And that is deep, you know, like to just know that you felt it. All right. So what's happening for this year for you, Bling Man? Now, what that is there any spoilers? Like, are you gonna be on EastEnders or?
No, we're not on EastEnders, yo, man.
Not time
for EastEnders, you know.
No, but what's it? What? Bro, you're the fastest growing. Yeah, I never say up and coming. I say up and growing comedian, and I'm like proud of that because I like to see them do their thing. And he's bringing in all the other people. Ain't just like selfish like other certain man them just there. Like man's bringing in people, Junior Booker, Abs, all them people he's bringing in. Yeah, don't get twisted. But where do you see comedy going? Because it's kind of at the moment it's kind of one-sided at the moment. You get me?
Yeah, you understand?
You see me? I said too many man that's like, who hold up the thing, you know?
Yeah, you see, in the UK comedy scene right now, what me see is you have individuals and then you have a group. You have groups of people.
Okay.
You understand what I mean? You have some individuals where them they pan them there where them want for there are them they high up in a for them career. Mm-hmm. Where them no need to look and help nobody or nothing like that. You understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Then you have groups where if you're not in with their group,
in their clique.
Yeah, you know, for them clique, you're not one of them. You get me?
Mm-hmm.
And that's how it is. I'm an individual that is out there finding my way. But along the way, I don't mind helping other people and bringing on other people because in the idea, there's food out there for everybody to eat. You understand? Right? But some people feel like the food are just for them alone. And them sitting with the food till it spoil. And they can't eat the whole life. Yeah, a real thing, man. A real thing, man.
So do you see the UK scene getting bigger like them, like America? Or is it still kind of like
It have a long way to go. And a real talk, it have a long, long way to go. Like, me I witness it myself because nobody no want to help you. The thing is that they will help you. Not even help you. They will be friends with you in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Say, I do your thing. Them see you come up. Mm-hmm. Them see you watch up on stage and say, yo, that youth are good. They will talk with you. Say, yo, you're doing good, you know, and ready this and ready that. You're cool, cool. But you see, as soon as you get to a part where you just step one step above them and people start talking about you more than them,
problem.
You realize them people start no want talk to you. No one, it's a hating thing in the comedy game in the UK. People don't like to see a next person reach nowhere.
A real talk.
You know what I mean? Them don't like it. Them just want them alone reach everywhere. Or if them can't have something, you not to have it. You understand what I mean? Them don't like it. Like right now, enough comedian over here. I mean, and I say me not care. Enough of them out there don't like me. Not for them.
Are you serious? No, bro. This and all right. You're talking from your view, innit? So you know, innit?
Well,
you're true.
My mother emailed me too.
Is it? Oh, what she want?
Oh,
sure. Who's there hating? Nah, big man. See, from my perspective, not a guan. But obviously, you feel it because you know, innit?
Yeah, man.
You feel it. No, it hurts me to hear that.
Yeah, man. Me dear, sure, man, and me witness it from the beginning where me they are sure and you can just tell the vibe with how some people deal with it. It's like them after them click and them staying after them click and you with the same show with them backstage with them and it's like you almost feel like you're not one of the comedian them. But me not care as me say, you know, get me because in the idea, me not there to please a comedian, you know, and me not there to try and make friends. Me never come in a comedy game to make friends. You have sites for them thing there, you get me? You have apps and them thing there, you can get make friends upon it. Me not come upon, you know, this a game for make friends. So enough of them will feel like me and them for friend. Me not want a friend with you, no. You get me? Because I don't know any type of friend with me want. Me coming out, me I do this for my family.
Oh.
For them have a better life. And me I do it for the people them where I support me from day one with my videos and then from me going to stage. So at them, me do, anything me I do for them. So when next comedian wants to know he hit for me, I'll waste your time.
wicked. But random questions, big man. Like, so basically my favorite show at the moment is Cheaters. I love Cheaters, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Love the show, but also my favourite film, favourite thing.
Why you watch it?
Right, Cheaters. Because I want them to come do one like in the UK. It's just something about.
You want to see if y'all get catch? Yeah, practice, innit? You want to see the things in where the man might get catch.
You understand? Be a so top
you,
of the game.
So you don't get catch when yeah. I do research.
Nah, I'm a dep on it. But I want to be the host, innit? Do you understand what I'm saying? Properly do it. But I have a program I like, it's Come Dine With Me, innit?
Yeah.
I love a Come Dine With Me, you know. Love it, love it. But if you had to invite three people to your table, yeah, fiction or non-fiction, who would you invite?
Wow.
Three people.
Three people, alright. Would I invite 50 Cent?
That's a new one. Okay.
Would I invite 50 Cent?
Okay. I won't ask why yet, but go on.
Yeah. Would I invite...
That's a good one, you know.
Would I invite fiction and non-fiction, you say?
Non-fiction, they can be dead.
Okay.
Can raise them from the dead right now.
All right. Scratch 50 Cent. When I invite... I want to come in now, rise up people from the dead, why not? Yo, alright.
Go on. Yeah. Right.
They invite Tupac.
Bro, okay. You stepped it up higher now, okay.
And Biggie.
Whoa, okay. On the same table?
Yeah, man. Okay. I'm going to hear what's going on.
What really happened?
Yeah, I'm going to know what really going on, man.
Okay.
And I'm not get them food if they tell me what's going on either. Can't go back and them brave.
Go on. One more now.
I'm going to invite Shakira too.
Shakira? Is she?
You know Shakira?
The singer. The singer?
Yeah.
Why her?
For me, look upon them while the rest of them are talking it.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
You can always be a man at your table.
That's what I was going to say, because I thought you were going to do another three. Who would you rate the most before, like, Biggie or Tupac? You have to pick one.
I'm going to throw
Biggie.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to throw Michael Jackson and Bob Marley in the mix. So, alright, you got four of them now. Yeah. Who would you pick?
I would definitely pick Bob Marley.
Okay.
I mean, reason why I would pick Bob Marley, obviously, you know, fellow Jamaican. And that's why I would say with Biggie, kinda. Because I know Biggie background, Jamaican, you get me?
Aye.
You know, so that's why I wouldn't pick Michael Jackson.
Why not?
This might make a number of people that watch this might be like, what? I've never been a Michael Jackson fan.
Bro, you never done the moonwalk, never wanted to do the moonwalk.
Never, man. Never.
You never been sitting on the telly like, waiting.
No, man. Never.
There's not one tune you like?
Nope. No, let me listen to one, two, and tune them, but me's not a fan, like, if you say, oh my god, Michael. When he passed away, me never even did bit for no, like. Honestly, I'll be honest, and everybody like, I don't say everybody have to like this.
Nah, it's true, not. That's why we're so unique and the world's so beautiful. What's your favorite word?
My favorite word?
Yeah. Or phrase?
I always say, yo, people.
Yo, people.
At the beginning of my video, then, if you
ask yo, people. And then you have one container, and if you have two container, bro, that was the most, you know what I loved about that video, because it was so universal. Yeah, it was for everybody, like, you know when it goes round and it comes back to you, and your granddad passes it, you're like, granddad, you watch, you understand? That's what I knew. I said, you know what, that's when I know that you've touched everybody. Do you get what I'm saying? And all ages. I said, man, come with the. And then what did I do Christmas? Me come with my container, no lid. And just for a joke, I was doing that. You get what I'm saying? The ice cream tub, four of them. You get what I'm saying? And they put
my gift.
That's amazing. So, all right. I don't know if you believe in God or anything like that, yeah?
Mm.
But you're at the pearl gates now. What would you want he or she to say to you? You can't find me, gotta, as I'm chewing, you know, playing, me flexing, you know, gotta get a man. Oh no!
They're from the gates, one with that one.
Yeah, what would you want to say? Because you lived your life now, innit?
Yeah.
You've done everything you needed to do. What would you want he or she to say to you?
Well done.
And come in.
Well done, son. You're welcome.
All right. Well, it's been great, bro. And thanks. And that'll be £5, please. for, and yeah, that'd be £5, please, for the
£5
for the taxi.
For you have skill. Can weigh up something £5. What do you mean?
No, it's £5 for the journey. That was it. Now
£5 a what? £5 a flour. £5 a sugar.
Pounds. Five no, pound pa- £5 note. The blue thing, the queen with the queen's head on it, Mr. Prince Harry. Okay. Yeah. So I know you know.
You have child up on him, do you?
Yes, I do. Oh, no, I don't. I should have put it on though. But why didn't I put it?
My jeans kind of tight.
So what do you mean? So you need to get it out?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That's cool. That's cool. Yeah, it's Max, the cab driver. I'll take it there. I might even chat to you and give you a cold interview. Talking all types of things like media, politics, knowledge is power. Remember, it's my view and my view only. If you don't like it, come out my cab.